Hi, I'm Lyla Fujiwara. I'm a course developer here at Udacity, and these are my thoughts on crappy interviews. So this is kind of funny because interviews are like a little bit the bane of my existence. I'm sort of like, I've thought about this story a little bit, but I'm shaking a little bit right now just because I'm being asked a question. In my senior year, you know, a lot of people were applying to go work in big tech companies, and I was sort of thinking about it, but I wasn't quite sure what I wanted to do with the rest of my life. And sort of one of the things in my mind was like, well, I have this very clear path for what I can do. I'm gonna have this degree. It could probably get me into like a really nice tech company and I could just keep doing what I'm doing. But at the time I was a little bit, you know, just questioning if that's what I wanted. Anyways, I had TA'd for this professor who's actually a leader in graphics, the field of graphics, and had been a TA from one of his larger classes. And I think this is what got me on sort of the short list for a list of students that a large tech company was particularly trying to recruit. So I, you know, got this invite and I kind of like didn't respond for a while and I'm like, oh, whatever, free trip out to the West Coast. So I did it, I went there, and I got put in, it was either my first or my second technical interview. And technical interviews are super stressful, I feel like. Partially just because they're so exhausting. They're like 10-hour ordeals, or at least this one was. And you're being bussed around and meeting all the different teams. And I remember early in the morning of that interview talking to a guy who's super friendly, and I was like having a good conversation with him. But we were talking about printer drivers. And in the back of my head, while I'm trying to answer questions for this guy, I'm thinking, oh, printer drivers, that's like the most boring thing I could ever think of. And I talked to some other people during that interview experience. There's a part that I don't remember quite how I flubbed it, but I was talking to a guy about like how a web page was put together with like how it's actually parsed on a server, and I had no idea how that was actually done, and you know, he was getting kind of frustrated with me or whatever. You know, but I got fairly long or far along in the process. So, you know, I was feeling, you know, pretty good at myself. I'm like, oh, I just, you know, breezed through this interview. Yeah, sure, I messed up some things with like a scene graph and a web server or something, but you know, I'll be fine. And about a week later, I got a phone call, you know, saying, which is probably fairly obvious to you, that I didn't get the job. And I was kind of sitting there and feeling really sorry for myself. But, you know, I think the thing that I got out of it and kind of what I want to convey, I guess, to Udacity students is that, like, I wasn't really supposed to be at that interview. I wasn't actually, like, particularly, like, that job wasn't something that I was particularly interested in. I didn't really take ownership for the job application process. And later, so actually what I did end up doing was, instead of going off and working at a big tech company, I went into the Peace Corps and I taught for 2 years. And after coming back to the Peace Corps, and a similar thing was like, oh, I should apply to like these large tech companies and do the whole interview process. But one of the things that I did differently the second time around was in a dusty Kenyan market, I bought this book called What Color Is Your Parachute? Which is like a quintessential career guidance book. And one of the sort of silly things that it made me do was walk through a series of exercises to learn about, you know, what actually is important to you, what you're interested in, more than just, you know, what your skill set is or what you happen to get your degree in. And through doing that, I was like a lot better able to verbalize what I wanted. And, you know, as I was going through the job search, I didn't apply to a lot of jobs, which, you know, on paper looked kind of good. You know, like if I got hired there, it would be a good thing to brag to my family and friends about or whatever. But, you know, they weren't jobs that I was actually interested in. And the first job that I applied for was Udacity. And I read the job description. I went, this is perfect. This is awesome. And this is where I want to be.